psychological gap or the emotional and psychological gap has been left. See, most people don't remember their minds and their hearts whenever it comes to things to do with treatment. People always take care of their body. Ukishikwa na homa, ukishikwa na corona, ukishikwa na diabetes, mtu atakibia clinic na atibiwe vizuri sana. But people will seldom remember their emotional na psychological conditions. And I like Father Simon a lot because he keeps on, he is a man who insists on that kind of healing. He will talk about forgiveness. He will talk about inner healing. He will keep on insisting and insisting and insisting. And most of us are wounded people. Even by virtue, do you know that you can be wounded by anything? Anything can wound you. You're in the womb of your mother and your father rejects you. You reject your mother, definitely not you. Rejects, and immediately that rejection goes into her head and her mind and her heart. It is transmitted to you as you are in that womb. Immediately. Yeah? Even if you are conceived in an unlikely manner, maybe mama na baba walipigana and then that is the night you are conceived. You are conceived out of confusion. So you will not live a very confusion-free life. You will be confused a lot in your life. You will find confusion pursuing you everywhere you go. So this ignorance of emotional conditions and psychological conditions is what I call black hole. I call it black hole. So in my theory of addiction, I say that if your addiction, whatever it is, it might be the easiest of things, pengine ni chai. Utakunywa chai nicotine, ukunywa chai yako vizuri every time socially. Then the day you shall go and take your tea, courtesy of a heart feeling, a pain. Now your addiction finds your black hole. The next reason for now taking your tea will be because it relieves you of stress. Mimi kikunywa tu kombe ya chai nasikianga stress zimepungua. Your addiction has found your black hole. Now wewe kuiacha chai haitakuwa kazi moja rahisi. It will be a difficult agenda. Now look at, let me give you an example of women. Women have a tendency not to speak out our problems. So, and that's why we have inanimate, I call them inanimate stress releasers. That is why a man can sit with a brown bottle and have a deep conversation. Wanaangaliana tu. And they are having a very deep one, a very intimate one. In fact, bibi angekuwa hiyo chupa angefurahi sana. And they are having an intimate moment. Lakini ana regurgitate, anakula vitu tu kwa kichwa kikuu, anazuazua akiwazua. Little do they know that They are giving an open door to their addiction. So the addiction finds the black hole, an incapacitation in their psychological and and emotional health. So haujaweza kudeal na ile hali yako ya umeumia ama hasira ama stress, haujaweza kudeal nayo, lakini ulevi yako imeipata. Kutoka hiyo wakati utakuwa ukikunywa na stress. Stress ikikushika kwa ba na ukiteremsha hiyo kapiri sina baridi ukaekelea chini hivi nikaa unakuanga na instant premonition. Wow, hey, vitu ziko sawa sasa, leta vile tulivyo. And that is the end of your salary now because it has your addiction has, you have connected it to your emotional incapacity, your psychological incapacity. Instead of a doctor, ukikuwa na homa, mafua, ama pneumonia, you don't find your bottle, you find who? The doctor. Doctor anakupatia antibiotics, anakuambia wewe ukikunywa hii antibiotics na pombe, umekata roho. Unasema ndio daktari. And temporarily for 5 days, hautaguza any addiction, courtesy of fear of death. Alafu utaenda kutoa lock. After the medicines are over. God is good. By the way, I never knew it was true. Till a friend of mine died. Ali teremusha pills na nini na pombe. kunywa pills zake za antibiotics, akakunywa pombe, and in 2 days the man alipata sijui ugonjwa ilimpeleka, ana sweat, and he died. So I nikasema, hey, whatever the doctor says, please believe it. Now, are you understanding when your addiction finds? Ni kama hata mtu wa kahawa, mimi nimekuwa Ethiopia and they really love their coffee. And it can be a social thing, drinking coffee socially. Then one day you go and take your coffee as you are wallowing in your emotional incapacitation. Unakunywa hiyo kahawa. Then you have invited the coffee into your emotional dilemmas. It has found your black hole. Stopping that coffee addiction shall be trouble for you. Utakukiacha kichwa inakugonga ning ning ding mpaka unashindwa what's so difficult by just leaving coffee. You have entered and it has found your black hole. Now to fast forward into what I'm trying to tell you. So are you aware of your mental condition? That's the question I want us to ask ourselves, a reflective type of a question. Are you aware of your mental condition? Ebu uliza, jiandikie hiyo swali kama uko na pen and paper. Are you aware of your mental condition? Then question number 2, are you aware of your emotional condition? Are you aware? Kwa sababu ukivunjika mguu utakimbia mara moja kwa hospitali, uwekwe cast na uanze kushughulika, mguu uanze kupona. Lakini ukivunjika roho, ukiwa na mental breakdown, na and sometimes we get mental breakdown kama sasa hii wakati wa COVID. If some of you, I don't know if you were under salary, I don't know if were you under salary? Eh? Salary ni mzazi kuleta mtoto shule. So kama aleti mtoto shule, hakuna salary. Do you know that that in itself can be a very serious mental condition? The moment unaambiwa na mtoto dadi mkate ya kesho asubuhi, and you have no idea where hiyo mkate itatoka. Na watu wote unaweza kopa, ulikopa while you are rich. Now when you are poor, you cannot even face them. So you find yourself emotionally and psychologically incapacitated by a simple question by your son. Dadi wapi mkate ya asubuhi? Na unagonga stress levels haziko. Na tatizo ya kukua na drunkard buddies and smoking buddies is that they will help your addiction find your problem. They will drink to it, kunywa umalize hii stress. Na hata kuweka hata shilingi moja kwa mfuko, akuambie enda nayo. Hata kuweka. Wewe kama wewe ni mlevi na uko hapa, umewahi bariki mtu ukamwambia usikunywe leo, shika hii 300 uende ununulie watoto nyama? Si hata wewe umekuwa na ni vile unioneshi, lakini umeshtuka kwa roho. Aje mimi nikupata? You know, one time I went with my drunkard some drunkard buddies of my friend. So I was helping him in his wedding. So wakaniambia watu wale wanaenda kunitolea pesa wako kwa bar. So mimi nimekaa pale chini, alafu watu wanaoda. There was a guy who really wanted to sponsor the first drinks for everybody. Alafu mimi nikasema stoni baridi kubwa. Nilisikia meritot. Jilipie hiyo. Sema rejection. Mara nikakumbuka marehemu babangu. Unajua babangu after class 8, when I had also gone for circumcision, my dad told me, "You are a man now. So should you want to change your orange bottle to my brown bottle, just say the magic words. Ninunulie and I will drop it." I looked at my dad in the eyes because he had taken me to a private session with him, because a table of men, he was bringing me to the table of men. I looked my dad in the eye. Nikakumbuka the times that I have been hated. Mimi, I was a favorite son. I have been hated by my siblings because I was a favorite to my dad. I would go clubbing with him every other weekend. Mimi, after shule, weekend tuko na dad, tumeenda clubbing. Me, I would do nyama and soda while he does his drinks. But now he's graduating me into the table of men. He tells me, ukitaka kutoka kwa orange bottle to my brown bottle, just say the magic words. Nikakumbuka mama yangu vile analianga, nikakumbuka ile mateso, the rest. I am the only one who knows how good my dad is. No one else knows. 8 kids, the only one who knows ni mimi. Kamwambia, "Hey, daddy, let's just agree here. Afu mimi ndio uito usiku, ni muingize kwa nyumba." Taxi men wote walikuwa wananijua, taxi drivers walikuwa wananijua, nilikuwa naitwa my son, because that's the language my dad, he never called me by name. My son. Hey, even if walikuwa nani, everywhere. So kila mtu alinijua my son. So nilikuwa nasikia tu mtu ameniita taxi man amekuja home, "My son." Najua ni mimi. Nobody, my mother, my siblings, nobody can wake up and bring in my drunkard dad. So mimi napewa mzee mzito, namwekelea mkono hapa, naenda nikianguka. I bring him into the house, he goes to sleep. I remove his shoes, I remove. Then I thought, is that the life I really want? So I looked him in the eye and kaambia, "Dad, I don't want to be like you." So no. My dad almost fainted. He almost collapsed. He didn't imagine the favorite son is saying no to him. I'm like, "Hey, dad, I've been with you enough. You know, I'm the one who has been hanging out with dad. Na nimekuwa nikiona venye barmaids wanagongangwa. I have been the one who is hanging out. I have been seeing everything. I know him through and through. I know him better than my mother. So, mimi, nikuwe kama yeye, nimwambia, no, daddy, no, I am not going to be like you. I choose today never to be like you." Niangalia karibu wa faint. And I made my choice and I took my path. I was not saved by Jesus from the bottle. My father saved me himself. Kamwambia, "Hiyo pombe ni yako, kunywa milele mimi. You have drunk for me and my generations. What you have done is good for us." I appreciate. In fact, I am drunk. I am, simuna niona vile nina behave. I am a drunk guy. He drank everything. And so, by virtue now, I am able to face my life soberly. I never saw my dad. My dad was also a very good orator like me. But he never appeared before a crowd without drinking. He never. So nikagundua, he had a mental incapacitation that his alcohol found out. And he was never ever able to distance himself. So anytime he wants to become the best, then he shines. Anytime he wants to be great, then he shines. Nikajiuliza, what did he miss? And today I'm giving you what he missed, and so that we may never miss it. So he missed on, when you have stress, there is a way of dealing with stress that you may not know. Let me ask you, whenever you are under stress, if I should ask quickly, what do you do? You are distracting yourself. If you are not aware of what you're distracting yourself with, it may take you down a bad road. Let's take, for example, watu wa kulala. They distract with themselves with sleep. Did you know that one of the criteria of diagnosing depression is sleeping? The depressed people tend to sleep a lot. They call it a stress reliever. It is called sleeping on it. So, but the person under stress will never know, because when they sleep, they tend to move, get unconscious of the happenings, and they sink into their place. So distractions are very dangerous, because you might distract yourself with something. And I want to invite you to the world of the sharers. Muzungu alisema, a problem shared, half solved. Whether the person you're sharing with gives you a solution or not, by virtue that you have been able, I want you to think of it like this. When you are under stress, physics teacher ko happy. When the balloon is being pumped, what is it exerting? What is the air exerting on the balloon surface? Pressure. So that is what stress does. It means you're being pumped in. You're being pumped in. Situations have pumped into you. So you are under pressure. When you sleep on it, have you exerted the pressure? Have you removed it? Well, I'm sorry, I'm not saying anything bad. It's taking water. When you have taken water, have you removed the pressure? Or you have increased it? I know you're beginning now. Put in the place of water, put alcohol, put bang, put every other thing. It's the same methodology of water that is used by bang people. One time, my friend, we went with him to a very wise woman. After school, when we dealt with the school, this wise woman said, asked my friend, will you take tea? My friend said, I am a Luya man, I take tea. So akakunywa, he cleaned a whole thermos all by himself. Thermos mzima. Ule mama akamwambia, unakuanga mlevi? Akasema nilikuwa. Akasema hiyo ulevi haijakuacha. So it's the similar concept. So it's a principle of distraction. You distract yourself with a particular thing, and that is how also addictions formulate. Mmenielewa mpaka hapo? So when you are under pressure, remove the pressure. Open the valve, release some pressure till you feel you're safe. So that is where now, for us psychologists, we bring in the issue of confidentiality. The easiest way to pump more pressure on someone is they share with you, see what may release what is pressuring them. Then you share with someone else. Then that story, when it comes to them, it is more inflated. So it will give them more pressure. So that is why the issue of confidentiality with the person, if you are not, and you can easily notice someone is sharing with you. Whenever you hear someone sharing with you something that is not right, that is not okay, they are releasing pressure. So guess what? Psychologically inform yourself, mudomo funga. Funga mudomo. Usiambie mtu. My wife accuses me that you share with some very serious things with your clients and haunichanui mapema, hauniambii mapema nikienda kukutana nao. Nasema, forgive me, confidentiality. I am like a priest in confession. Can never say. It can never come out. So it is important that you become a confidential type of a person. And that's why as a team, it is for your mental health, emotional health. Learn how to keep each other's secret. Mwalimu mmoja akikuja akule ngumi mwalimu mwingine hapa juu ya keskendo. Wacha kuenda kukunywa nayo pombe. Hii leo shule. Wa. Wamekutana mangumi na mateke. What are you doing? You are pumping more pressure. Principal, thank God hayuko. Amepigia mtu makelele. Na nyinyi mmeona, wacha kuenda kupatia chama ya wa mama. Kuleni tano. Umesikia leo kuna ame. Just know wherever you are pumping pressure on the person who was on the receiving end. So you immediately become part of the stress factors za huyo mtu. And I have noticed when we are colleagues and we are working together, if we are not cognizant of that aspect of pressurizing one another, we may unconsciously pressurize each other into places and corners. Na unakuta mtu mwingine hakuwa introvert, lakini juu ya ile pressure mulimweka, anapata new personality, anakuwa introverted. Never says. So they die with their issues, but they don't trust the people around. And so as you work together, Ebu, just ask your mwalimu next to you, can I trust you with some issues, one or two? Let me help us. Whenever you are sharing somebody else's pressure, you are never, when you are not the one under pressure, it is never something that you are aware. It is more of a sweet thing to your ears. You know, like these three pastors, they went out for a boat ride on a retreat center. Akasema, you know, sasa we are just the three of us pastors, you know, let's just share what is in our hearts and our congregation so that tukitoka hapa tuwe tu tumetoa tu kila kitu. Moja akasema, ayayaya, mimi wacha tu niseme. Mimi, those women in my church, they kill me. I can never keep away from them. Unajua nimelala na hawa mama wa kanisa yangu. Kadhaa, na unajua mabwana hata hawana habari, so anafungua moyo. Nataka ndugu zangu mniombe sana, mniombe ili Mungu anisaidie hii pepo ya last iniondoke. Mwenzake akasema, pastor umesema kitu ya maana, na mimi wacha niseme ile kitu inanisumbua. Mimi wacha nikuambie, sadaka mimi si bembelezangi, sadaka mimi naiba. Unajua what I declare to the committee na kile nimechukua ni tofauti sana. Huwa nagawa nusu ama three quarter na wapa tia kuota wapange nao mambo ya kanisa. Niko na shida, mniombe tamai niondoke. Alafu watatu na yeye akafungua mdomo akasema, hata mimi nitaomba tu pia mimi nikumbuke sana. Niko na matatizo sana. Kama sasa mimi naamini huwa siwezi kuweka kitu yoyote siri. Siwezi kama saa nachomeka kuchomeka. Naomba sasa vile nitatoka hapa. You should have seen the two pastors. They almost drowned themselves. They almost just drowned. They are finished. So, please, my brothers and sisters, I will tell you this. You may never know, but keeping the vices of your community private is one of the healing instruments that there are. You tell me, when Jesus was brought that woman with the alishiko, caught in the act, whoever they were caught with, I don't know where they were, but they brought only the one caught in the act, but the one who they were with, they was never brought. So Jesus just starts scribbling down, and they're insisting, we need to stone this woman. Trust you me, Jesus was seeing through her. And you know, maybe alikuwa naona hata the men that have been with her wako tu hapa nao pia wako na mawe kwa mkono. But Jesus never exposed them. Do you know that? He only said, if you have no sin, be the first one to do what? To throw a stone. Do you know, when he woke up like this, there was nobody except the woman. So he asked the woman, where are they? And the woman says, they have gone. So what did he say? The Son of Man neither condemns you. Yet, he was aware. Kila kitu hata alikuwa anawaona. Wewe mlikuwa na yeye kwanza juzi. Wewe mlikuwa na yeye. Alikuwa anawaona, but he never condemned. So sisi not speaking about our brethren's vices, weaknesses, is healing in itself. It is saying we are not here to condemn you. I am not saying that you approve of their character. I am just saying that you mind your own. It is their own. This, and that is mental health I am giving you. Mental health 101. Mwalimu akikuwa na weakness yake, it is none of your business. Your business is only one. Give him love. Shower him with love. Appreciate him the way we are. Jana tulisema our not so awesome things in a very nice way. Kuna mtu alifeel condemned. Hakuna. And then you realize, kumbe sisi wote tukona kaugonjwa ama kawalaki ni kadogo na tumekua hapa pamoja and we have been living. And everyone felt appreciated because he also said something good about them, true or false. And that's what we need to focus on. So that we also, when we are a community like that, we will easily share. So someone atakuja kwa mwalimu amwambie tu, mwalimu niko na kajambo nataka kusema, kamenikula kichwa hivyo. Mwalimu hahitaji kuambiwa usiseme. Mwalimu anajua hivyo ameniambia imeisha, sitasema. So that you won't even need the services of some of us counselors. You will not need the services because you yourself have a way of releasing those pressures from yourself. And anyone has pressures, ask your wife, ask your husband. Everyone are gonna pressure. But if we have a confident place where we can throw and release pressure, things will act. Then I want to say something else. Now I'll give you 4 items that affect us psychologically and emotionally. that you need to be aware of, because they can affect you consciously or unconsciously. So these are the items. So number one, it is the issue of Adam when he was in the Garden of Eden. It is called loneliness. Loneliness is not subject to being with people. You can be with people yet experiencing loneliness. Loneliness is the aspect of you not being able to identify with anyone. That is what loneliness is in a nutshell. Not being able to identify with anyone. So it doesn't matter the surrounding. How many people are with you? And that's why you would see that famous comedian, Ali Jinyonga. And na alikuwa anachekesha watu, wakati watu wakashindwa, ai amechukua tu kamba akajinyonga. Maybe he was experiencing loneliness. There was no one to identify with him, and that was the problem that Adam was suffering with. Akapewa kazi ya kuname all the animals, akaona wako wawili wawili. There was no one to identify. And he felt, you know, the one who noticed the loneliness was not him, it is God. Akasema, "Sijali Adam, I got you. I will sort you out. So do not worry." So understand this. When you are lonely, you can make irrational decisions. You can make rushed decisions. You can You can make irrational decisions. You can make rushed decisions. You can also make confused permanent decisions. Because you are not advised of a place of peace, you are advised of a place of loneliness. And so you make your decisions based on your innate issues that are happening to you. And students have that capacity. A student can be in your class, and teachers have the capacity to spot some of these people. You people somehow are graced with that capacity. And you see someone and you're like, that's a loner. Now, if you're wise enough, you will approach them. If you are unwise, utasema, mind your own business. And you will ignore the person. But it is always important to be aware when you are aware. Be aware when you are aware. Because it is not just out of foolishness that you are becoming aware. It is your natural system picking out a problem. So learn to also approach the problem, whether you have a solution or not, to just do something called listening. Mambia, would you like to speak to someone? Even if it's not me, I might refer you to someone. And you get near to this person. And the more you get near to this person, there was once this young boy, alikuwa anaitwa Kamau. Kamau was the most stubborn boy in class, always looking for attention. He would be so mischievous that it irritated every teacher in that class. But the class teacher one time came into this classroom, and Kamau had an ingenious thing. So he went under the desk yake, pushed the seat so that it is next to the desk. So obviously when the teacher comes in, sees there is no person. So Kamau is there under. So the class is laughing. So the teacher starts, because you know sometimes when you're not how shikanishi kenye kinaendelea, you choose to ignore so that you will be able to find out in time. You will find out truly. It has always happened, true. So you shall find out either way. So mwalimu akaendelea na lesson, but the kids are laughing because Kamau down there is also doing things. Doing things down there. So the class is, every time there is a laughter, all those things. So the teacher is disturbed. Half the 20 minutes in, disturbed, not knowing what's going on. Then she turns to the blackboard to write. Because the writing takes around 15 minutes so that the kids can copy, Kamau slowly pushes the seat, sits down, and starts writing as they are writing. So 5 minutes to time, she turns around and the class is full. And she can't, you know, hajashikanisha. She can't pick what's going on. And she's wondering, the class is full. What did I miss? I thought there was a seat that was empty. No, she, you know, because she's teaching, she's not able to decipher many things. So she's, and just before she walks out after the bell, and I say, kama umetoka wapi? And the class, and she was so hurt. But in the midst of her pain and suffering, akenda staff room akishare too heavy. She thought, you know, because walimu alimwambia enda ukauwe, enda umalize huyo mtoto, enda, you know, walimu alikuwa amechocha. Okay, sisemi ni nini. Wamechocha, enda umalize yeye, sijui nini. So mtoto akaenda, so mwalimu in that maybe she decided to just think about it. Because she had aired out her pressure, now she had time to think about it. She just thought about it. She said, let me... In the evening, she comes back to the class when just before they leave and says, Kamau, let me go home with you. Kamau, kamambia pana, you can't come home. Kasema, please. Okay, wacha nikuzindikishe, nikufikishe kwa mlango yenu. Wakati walifika kwa mlango, vile tu Kamau aliguza gate hivi, jina alisikia jina yake ikiitwa na whoever the woman was inside that house. So loudly. Kama umechelewa wapi? Mama akashindwa, huyu ni nani ameitana hivyo? So wakati Kamau akashrink, akiwa kwa gate akashrink, akakimbia ndani. Ameshrink kabisa mpaka mwalimu akashindwa, kuna mtu ukomesha Kamau? Yani kuna mtu hii dunia? So she waited at the gate, then walked in slowly. And Kamau was abused from the time he entered that gate. Alikuwa na receive insult after insult. Kamau, 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 Kamau this, Kamau that. And Kamau was so all over the place, not knowing what he's supposed to do or not supposed to do. And then the mama, the teacher knocks the door. Akaingia akakaa. Ule mama kwanza, unajua ilibidi amepumua. Juu sasa ile pressure alikuwa anaongelesha kama unayo amepatwa na alafu anauliza akauliza karibu sana wewe ni nani? Akasema Kamau sasa hiyo Kamau amestuka wondering why did you come here? I thought I told you not to come here. Why are you here? And the teacher says I am Kamau's teacher. Akasema oh, mwalimu karibu. Hey, leo haikuwa siku nzuri. Mtu anasemanga akikuja. So there she is trying to, and you know, for the first time it hit that mwalimu, Kamau may be one very, very lonely human being, but expressing himself in all the wrong manners, seeking attention, which no one is giving him. And the mwalimu decided there shall be no punishments for Kamau in my class ever again. So the mwalimu, every time when Kamau would mess up, akuwa na highlight Kamau. And you see, over time, by virtue of she was not highlighting Kamau, Kamau lost interest in doing those things because he was doing it in the first place for what? For attention. And now, no longer is the teacher giving attention. But then the teacher would still address it. Anaita Kamau badaye, wanaongea jana kulikuwaje, mama alikuambia nini. And Kamau would say, sometimes Kamau would cry. And now they became... connected. They became like, now she became the mother in school. She became the mother to Kamau. And Kamau would tell everything. She later learned that that woman was not actually Mama Kamau. Alikuwa stepmother. Mama Kamau alikuwa amekufa. So this was the stepmother raising Kamau. And Kamau, after wali bond, went into becoming the best student from the worst student in the class. But then, he had a life in school and a different kind of life at home, which the teacher could not address definitely, but at least made a little heaven for Kamau in the school. She would share even food with him. You know, I don't know. She just became nice to this Kamau. And Kamau changed his life completely. Loneliness. Loneliness is a very dangerous aspect. It can affect a husband seated in his house with the wife and the children. It can affect a teacher seated in a staff room and making everyone laugh. And they are very, very lonely. Mimi nasemanga hii ni fracture of the skull. Ni vile hautawai peleka, hautaienda kupigwa x-ray. So mimi leo nimekupiga x-ray. You are fractured if you are experiencing an identity crisis whereby you cannot identify yourself with anybody. It means you are going through an identity crisis and it is bringing a lot of loneliness to you by virtue of no one is understanding you and they are relating with what you are throwing to them. You know, they may be only relating to what you are throwing. So you have to come to a place whereby you are accepted. And this is when you seek even professional help. Nasema, is there a counselor, psychologist, psychiatrist I can sit with and you we check out what went wrong with you so that you got into a place of loneliness. And this is also very dangerous also for addicts. Addicts who are very lonely, they find solace in their things. Let me give you and somehow, I don't know. Let me just give you this information since you... I am not telling you to go and condemn any of your students. Your students, most of them, sister, with your permission, are suffering from some weird addictions like pornography. So, what drives up some of these addictions could be, I'm not saying it is the only, could be loneliness. And this is what if we can come up with a community that cares, all of us, not just a few individuals, all of us decide we are going to care. And not forgetting the confidentiality thing I talked about. We are going to care. So it means now students will no longer only see us as teachers, but also someone that they can remove some pressure. And I am not telling you to have any solution. It is not necessary. Releasing pressure ni kufungua tu valve. Unaacha pressure, so you don't even have to have any solution. Ni unasikiliza tu unasema. Do you know I have listened to people and I just told them one word. I heard you. I have heard. And they have gone happy. And I only said I have heard. I never said anything else. I just said I heard you. And then I look in the eyes and I ask, do you trust that I have heard you? And they say, yeah, you listened. And I say, go. I am incapacitated, maybe. I don't know what to do or to tell them. I am not even planning to go into their shoes. But I gave them what? A listening ear. And that can be the hate of. Sometimes we do not require the wisdom of your mind through your mouth. Sometimes we just need the patience of your ears. And we are healed. And today I'm also inviting you, as you get healed mentally and emotionally for yourself, that become the instrument of healing. Become the instrument of healing. Whenever I have seen, one time I had a very wise teacher who used to teach us in my primary school. There's a time she would come and she would just say, you know, class, walimu wame complain about you sana. Can we just talk? And she destroys her English class. Destroys it with conversations. So, ni nini ndio mnapitia? And the whole English lesson goes down the drain. Hatujafanya English. And then she would leave the class and I say, ma, we may not have a solution, but at least we talked. Can we trust one another to keep things here? And we would feel the teacher so much, you know. By virtue of metuskiliza, tunasema, yes, teacher, we will not say. And we formed our own little family there. Our own little family. Yo darasa, the teacher kumbe alitupanga. Tukaingia box, sisi, wote. And we would feel so safe. Akikuja, we would feel so safe. Mwalimu wetu amekuja. One time she was very sick. We all asked for permission. Na venye watoto wananga courage, tulienda kwa principal. Please, teacher, we want to visit our teacher. Wakasema, can't you send representatives? Tukasema, no. All of us. So tulienda kwa mwalimu na alikuwa na space ndogo, wengine tulikuwa inje. She really cried. But you know, she healed us. We healed her back. We healed her back. What you give, you will receive back. Number, tuko number? Number two. Aya, failure. Did you know that failure is a an emotional and a psychological disease. If you didn't, now you know. Why am I calling it a disease? Have you ever planned to do something with everything you and you know, like it is, this is a sure thing, and then it does not work out? What does it do to your inner self? What does it do to your inner self? Failure. You knew this is sure, I am going to get it, and then what you get is a failure. A serious disappointment hits you, and if you're not careful, you can hit a depression. You think of even a businessman who ameritaya, mzee ameritaya hizo siku za 55 years before it was 60. Ameritaya ama amepewa retirement ya 50 years. Ameambiwa retirement, amepewa labda 250,000. Akasema 50,000 wacha nipeleke nyumbani. This 200 will set my next 50 years and puts it into a business. And then does the business for 3 months and the business collapses. The golden age ya nini, ya golden handshake, if you are old enough to remember, ilikuwa hapo 90s, kulikuwa na Moi was doing restructuring ya government due to IMF requirements, and they needed him to privatize. So in the privatization, many organizations walipatia watu golden handshake. Walevi wakakojolea watu kwa bar. Then the money was over. The genius ones, never done business for 30 years of employment, decided they are entrepreneur supreme. Entered into business. 3-6 months down the line, bankrupt. Men, enda muangalie hiyo age group ilipati wango. Most of them, stroke, heart attack, death, early deaths. Wakaacha wa mama. Wakiwa wana scratch from zero. But wa mama juu ya mshene, yani wanapenda kupiga mdomo. Wa mama wanapiga, uwe mzee aliniacha nikiwa na watoto 10. Sasa sijui nitaanzia wapi, kila mahali anapiga. Wa mama wanaenda kwa chama wanasema, hey, wacha tuone vile tutasaidia mama fulani. Wa mama wanaenda wanampelekea huko Equity Bank. Equity Bank inafundisha watu kuku how to invest. Unaona, hawako, they are not genius, hao ni wajinga. Wanasema, hatujui kuinvest, sisi mimi sitawahi kuinvest, nisaidie. Anafundishwa polepole, anaambiwa, usianze na pesa mingi, tutakupatia kwanza kaloni ya 10,000, uweke hivi, alafu tutakuwa tukiangalia biashara yako. Within some 6 months, mama amerudisha ile 10,000. Hey, wanampatia 50,000. Ivo, mama wa wenyewe hajawahi kufanya biashara. In 10 years, she is supreme. She is running business like nobody's business. and she has learned. How? Because she was able to release. Now, failure, on the other hand, can hit you a major blow. And I will give you how to deal with failure, because it is something that is never looked into. So number one, if you want to deal with failure, you need to accept it. You have to allow failure. And this, nothing lasts forever. Even this shall end. Uta retire, by the way. Ama utachoka, one or the other. Something shall remove you from here and you will start a new life. So if you did not allow yourself to fail, you will go there with everything. You will put all your eggs in one basket and you will throw them somewhere and they will backfire on you and you will collapse. High blood pressure, kisukari, what are the other things? They will all hit you, and if you have a multiplicity, you get a stroke, off you go, and you leave us early. Why are you leaving us early? Mwambia wendi mahali, mwambia tu jirani, hakuna kuenda mahali. Tusizoeane hapa. Wendi mahali, kaa hapa. We are not done with you. So, number two of dealing with failure is learn to take calculated risks. The entrepreneurs and the business teachers may understand this language that I am using. Learn to take calculated risks. What am I trying to say? Is that we have been created by God in a very creative manner. Meaning that God always deposits ideas into your system. God will always be depositing. Mungu hawezi kukupatia gift tu hivi ya walimu na anakuachanga. Huwa anakuzindikisha. Anaendanga na wewe kazi. So, ili ujue anaendanga na wewe kazi, he deposits in you some ideas all the time. But if you are not the person who takes calculated risk, you shall never implement some of these ideas God puts in you. And some of these ideas, God does not put them in you so that you may be excellent. Sometimes he just puts them in you that you may try them, that someone else may see what you are doing and be genius about it and think, what if I did it like this? And then they pick it up from you and they are able to come up with something. But if you are not someone who takes calculated risk, you are the ultimate mistake maker, which is called never taking any amount of risk. Then you shall never, when the day you will make a mistake, utakulwa na guilt from here to Timbuktu na utakufa. So you have to learn that you have to allow yourself to make calculations. That's how you develop. And I don't care how old you are. Learn now. The time to learn is now. You start now. Make calculated risk every time. Make. And that's how some of you are going to be able to do business. If there are people in this universe who are in of Kenya that have a lot of time in their hands sometimes, it is teachers. You imagine you go to holidays like students. Munaendanga. And especially after Matiangi, muliambo musifanya tuition na remedy. So unless unafanya chini ya maji, so you will always find yourself with an amount of time. So if you're not, that is your time to do some calculated risks. Don't wait for COVID-19 to mesmerize, perplex, and surprise you, man. You have no salary. Where were you? And you have been alive all this time. Learn to take calculated risk. I know I'm giving you golden words. You don't need to tell me. Number three, so that you are able to acclimatize yourself with. Number three is work on your belief system. Work on your belief system. So number three, work on your belief system. And with a chance of you thinking I'm just saying this spiritually, I am also saying it in all manners, whether it is normal life, I am talking about a general type of a belief. Belief is your ability to trust your instincts. That's the kind of belief I am describing here. Your ability to trust your instincts. Meaning that you may not have proper explanations to what you're feeling or thinking or intuiting, but you're choosing to believe it. That this thing I have inside of me, I am feeling, I have the audacity to believe it and try it. You think if Obama did not have the audacity to think, you know, an African can become an American president, if he didn't have that audacity, would he have ever stepped into the podium and tried to be senator and later to be president? He would never have tried. Some of us never try anything because there is an incapacitation in our belief system. So check there. Do you trust what you're doing? Do you trust, even let me go home a little bit, do you trust yourself? Imagine whenever you step in front of students, guess what? They trust you as the teacher to deliver what you're going to deliver. They trust. So just if you don't have trust in yourself, then trust, they trust you. Work with that. It is good enough. That is how I have even taught ministers and pastors and preachers. Sometimes priests ask me, how do you maneuver the word of God like that? Now I'm younger, number one. The one who trusts you with the word, which is God. God trusts you with the word. Trust that he trusts you. Then open your mouth. The rest will work from there. And since they have been well taught in their seminaries, they will always work out something. And so you have to believe in yourself. Every morning when you go, believe that today will be my best class. I shall deliver this class home and dry. But the moment ulikufa moyo na hao watoto, the issue was not them. It was you first as the teacher. I know they say that teachers, simunambianga students, I give you 25%, 75%, Niako. Now you in your 25%, this is what is required of you. Put your every faith there. Put your trust there that I am going to deliver an ingenious methodology to these people that they will understand me. And you see, when you have a belief system that works perfectly, people tend to believe people who believe. One time there was this man called Martin Luther. He said, I have a dream. Wa Afrika wenzake wakasema, yes, we too. And they followed him in the 60s. And they never took those buses. And they broke segregation in their country forever. That the dream one day appeared in Obama when he is posthumous. That is Martin Luther. So you believing may not suffice today, but it will suffice because you believed. This school was a dream. Sister, alikuwa anaitwa nani mwenye aliota? Mary. Saa hii mahali yuko, wherever she is, unafikiria ile smile. Yani, sister anaweza fikiria anafanya vitu geniusly, lakini she is fulfilling somebody's dream. Somebody who was able to visualize that thing in her head and in her heart and says, I see, I believe. So you have to look at your students and CAs. You are the first person to believe, not the student. The student will catch up with your belief system. If you believe it strongly enough, they will catch up with you. So if you have no way, hata unaenda, unacho siku moja niliitwa na Mrs. Saina wa Kenya High. Akaniambia, Dennis, wacha nikuambie. Hii shule A class form 4 wataniangusha. Mimi wataniangusha. Nikamuza kwa nini? Unaweza imagine for the last 2 years I have not been top 10. I have not been top 10 in this country. What am I going? Hawa wataniangusha. Belief system ya mwalimu wao iko chini. Nikasema, mwalimu, I shall deal with you later. Wachana na hiyo. Nipatie 1 week na watoto wako. Form 1, form 2, form 3, form 4, nilikuwa na waona separately discovering and discerning their issues, what is going through. And I was able to pick the differences in their classes and deal with them. But then when I got to form 4, kumbe the principles, ideology and belief had been transmitted. Remember the spirit of the artist. So alikuwa may transfer kwa staff room the unbelief she has over the students. So the staff now walikuwa napiga mdomo, nyinyi ni bure tu, hata hii darasa tu tunashindwa tu kama mtapita. So mwalimu anafundisha tu wapite, yani waende kwenye wanaenda. So mimi nikasema, I'm not going to address the staff room since I have not been given that permission. I am not going to address the principal until her specific time comes. So what I am going to address is the persons that I have been given, which are the students. So after we went through healing, the words that the teachers had spoken, their parents had discouraged them, we broke those words, we dealt with them, we visited every one of those words, and we said the most important words in your life are not the ones that people say over you, but the words that you say over yourself. And I gave them affirmative words to speak over themselves, and they were able to affirm themselves. And I told them, now we have a business. Me and you are comrades. We are going to fight this fight together. I believe you are all A students. I believe you are all A students. Now, anybody who is with me, can we work to prove wrong? All our teachers and parents. Tukaka kama sisi ni jeshi. Yeah! Kambia bas. We have 3 months to prove all these naysayers wrong. Mimi nilipigiwa na Mrs. Saina when the results za 2011 zilitoka za 2010 class. Wakaniambia, na munisi nyinyi ni walimu munajuanga results. Kenya High School number 8. Wale that were seen to be useless. They brought back the school to top 10. Mrs. Saina akaniambia, I don't know what you did. Ndio nikamwambia, her time for change came. Kamwambia, you did not believe. See, belief has the ability to supersede efforts. Belief has the ability to go beyond our human levels. Belief has the ability to bring the supernatural. When you operate your class with no belief, they work with you. They work with you. And you get your results. But when you form belief system, And you are very many ladies in this school. You can put belief system in the girls of this school. That they bring their A's, wakieka pale za boys ziko, either bumper to bumper ama wamepita hata boys. By instilling belief. And belief is so personal that you do not, no one can come and force you. You have to choose to believe. Believe in your style. Believe in yourself. Believe in your teaching methodologies. Believe in how you do your things that you're going. And you see, you shall never be passionate until you believe. Why you are listening to me with all your ears, toes, and fingers is because I believe in what I am saying. 100%. So I don't really care whether you believe, because I believe you will believe. And we have to get to that place whereby we believe in ourselves so much that when we go there, we don't care how poor, how ugly, how fornicated those kids are. We only know one thing, because I believe they will align themselves sooner or later. They will align themselves, and truly so, they shall align themselves, because belief has an ingenious way of bringing the supernatural. So if you want to tap, is belief. Now, nimemalizana na hiyo story ya failure. Aya, we move on to number three. Number three thing that you need to watch out for your mental psychological health is something called rejection. One time this lady dressed up nicely. She had been called for a date by this young man that alikuwa amependa, alikuwa anasema, akasema, this is my golden moment. I'm going to be somebody's girlfriend, nanini. And they went out and they talked, they had their food, their dinner, and they enjoyed themselves thoroughly. But the man was listening to her and decided to say, after the dinner, I don't think I want this. No, this is not good for me. Oh, mume nielewa. Kuna wale wa... Eh? You can imagine that heartbreak, eh? Then she went out and met this friend. And the friend, after kumuambia benye what happened with her dinner date, akamuambia, who can date someone like you? Look at your hair. Look at your toes. Look at your legs. Who can date someone like you? What do you feel about that, friend? Yes, Mwalim. What do you think of that, friend? What do you think? I am asking you because you may give me the right words. What do you think of that, friend? Not a good friend.
I think that is a good friend.
It's about the impact. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The only issue is that friend was not really a friend. It is her. She was speaking to herself. So she transferred rejection from without to... Are you getting me? People may call you a dog, but until you repeat it in your head, it will never affect you. You think the number of times you bad words have made you react. Why did they make you react? You repeated them in your head. Mimi ni umbo. Alafu naipea kanyama kidogo, naipea reflection. Miguine, mukia, ha, umbwa koko. So one time, three seminarians were going on a safari, and this dry areas, and sometimes they have to cross into different places walking. They are being sent by their parish priest. And so Wakivuka, there was a place, this sudden floods that happen in riverbeds that are dry. So you know, rain can come from the mountains, hivyo iteremkia hata mahali hakujanyesha. So there was flash floods, and they came to this, they were crossing, and there was this lady who was just waiting for the water ishe because she can't cross. A very beautiful lady. So wakienda kuvuka, one of the seminarians said, hey, let me carry this one. Akamweka kwa mgongo, akamvukisha. After they crossed over, akamweka chini. Na off they went. And they reached. Na kuambia, jioni hiyo, people are not talking to one another. I don't know. So the parish priest asked, what's wrong with you people? Kwani, what happened to your safari? Your apostolate today, what happened to it? And no one is talking. So one of them, I think, out of a lot of irritation, and say, ma, you know, Father, you teach us to be holy, and some people here feel like they cannot be holy like the rest of us. And then I said, no, what's the issue here? So the only person who's not understanding is the topic. Most of the time when you don't understand, maybe you are the topic. So see, the topic of the day does not understand what's going on. So one is, who is not holy here? So the other one jumps in, he says, you know, uyu alitulifika mahali, alibeba mwanamke kwa mgongo. A very beautiful lady, akamwekelea kwa mgongo, akamvukisha. Na si ulituambia tukue watakatifu. Father akawaangalia, akasema, acha niwaambie watoto wangu. How many minutes did you use to carry that lady? Kijana akasema, it was like 3 minutes. We crossed for 3 minutes. Since the crossing, how many minutes did it take you to come to this house? Wakasema, like 30 other minutes, so 33. And since it is, you came here at 7, and it is right now is 8:30. So do the mathematics. How many hours? Some 2.5 hours, yeah? So for 2.5 hours, you have been carrying that lady. 2.5 hours. This one carried the lady for 3 minutes. Nini, 2.5 hours. I think I know where the issue is. Can I go with you too and help you? So that you, first of all, put the lady down. The greatest issue of rejection is not that people can reject you. It's the fact that you can reject yourself. Whenever you choose to reject yourself, that is far more serious than any forms of rejection. I'll give you an example without mentioning name. From this school, yesterday I encountered a horrible case in the night that took me all the way to one. Mimi lala one wakati nyi mmekanyaga blanket. And there was a lady who was completely paralyzed. Alikuwa amekunjuliwa hivi. Miguu na mikono. I have never seen anything like that. So I found my colleague praying 1 hour, and open kasema, I don't like wasting my prayers. So I just said, please, what is her name? Let's bring her back. So we carried her, feeling pain, paralyzed, not moving, onto the seat. Kamuza, tell me, what is going on? And I discovered she has been rejected by everyone around her without giving her story so that you don't figure out. Everyone. That did not paralyze her. What has paralyzed her is the self-rejection. She has confirmed that she is good for. She has confirmed yeye ni umbwa. Aliitwa umbwa, akakubali. Aliitwa bure, akakubali. I am hereby informing you There is no amount of angry words that can be spoken to you that can affect you until you have repeated them to yourself. If you feel useless, there is nothing we can do about it. If you have no faith in yourself, there is nothing we can do about it. I can only fungua mdomo and try to speak. It is until you say, I am choosing to feel useful. I am choosing to feel I am not rejected. There is one priest, alikuwa anaitwa Father, aliandika kitabu inaitwa You're Not, Parakamilil, Muindi, wa Vincentian. And he wrote a book called You Are Not Rejected. It is this narrative that we give to ourselves of rejection that incapacitates us. So we have to wake up to those words. And that's why if you read the book of Isaiah, the one that people sometimes people like a lot, in a no-evens fashion, Isaiah 54:17. Just stand there. I show you the second part. Just stand. Isaiah 54:17. I have to put down those words that have been raised against me in judgment. That's are the words I have to refute, meaning that if you are living somewhere and you're feeling rejected, you have to refute those words. So if you necessary, speak to yourself, sema nakata hiyo maneno, mimi si umbwa. Mimi si useless. Are you getting me? Before even addressing why you have been called useless, I need you to address the words. Because if you don't address the words, you might address the problem and you stay with the words. And you see, the results, the one who is telling you useless will be happy because you have addressed the results. But you will never be happy because you have gone with the rejection that you are still useless. So this useless person has addressed because they originally was useless, but you have gone with the rejection. You have stayed with the rejection. So you have to address the words. So I don't know how many words you have ever heard while growing up, your father say, some of you have ended up as far as your father kept you. Where your father kept you, Maria alikuwekea kifuniko utafika, ndio umefika. And you have never gone beyond that. So you never refuted the words. You never said no to those words. You never canceled out those words. You never rejected and threw them out of you. You have to, even the Lord said, you know, what goes into you is not what harms you. It is what comes from, because it comes from your heart. And that is where emotional and psychological condition is. And many are suffering, sick and hungry and lonely and rejected, but they never say it. And they are feeling useless. Every morning you're waking up to your classroom, you're feeling, and the students are confirming how useless you are by talking while you're talking. Who will hear who? You know, can I tell you something about children? Children are born with their super ego is not as developed as their id. Id is the innate, that instinctual behavior. And they develop their super ego more perfectly when they are maturing in their teenage life. When they are here, that's when they are developing their super ego. The ability to stop themselves. I like calling it that. The ability to just control themselves. So they are developing it. So meaning that they are still very sharp in their innate. That character whereby they are so random. I want it now. No, I'm hungry. They're like the baby cries immediately because they want instant satiation. Now, the problem with people who operate, they are animalistic. Have you seen how animals, do you know that dogs, they will only pursue you if you have fear in yourself? Dogs have the ability to smell fear. So ukiona umbo imekukimbiza, you know the state of your heart. You are dying inside while running. And look at even when dogs bark around you. When they will never approach you if your inside has nothing to fear. But if you are so scared, you will see the dogs approaching you because they can smell fear. It is that ability. Now, children have also that ability. They pick it unconsciously. Wewe unakuja na self-esteem iko kwa viatu, yani low self-esteem. So unconsciously they pick your low self-esteem. So every word that will come from their mouths will put you further down, deeper. You will not leave that class with a high self-esteem. You will leave with a lower self-esteem. They have dealt with you a blow. And I remember even me when I was in high school, I used to be that very instinctual. Now I know because I have done a lot of self-reflection. And I remember one time this chemistry teacher from Nairobi University, amekuja kujintroduce, amekuja, he walks in sheepishly, timidly into the class. And I spot it. I was the tiniest in the class. I had not grown tall. So it's, I don't know why short people compensate with their mouth. So, so mimi ndio huyo. And guys used to know me in class. They used to say, wait for it. So I am there. The teacher walks in and starts introducing himself. My name is... The moment he just starts saying his name, before he hits the second name, I open my locker as if retrieving a book. And you know, that desk, when you open it, it does not, it blocks your sound. So your sound goes back in a rudi huko nyuma. So haitatoka hapo, itatoka nyuma. Nikafungua nikasema, and where were you harvested from? Nikatoa kitabu yangu, nikaekelea juu ya meza, the class collapsed laughing. Mimi nikiamka, since I wasn't laughing, so you know you have to camouflage. I was looking at the teacher. Nikaona self-esteem ya mwalimu ikienda kwa viatu. Ushaiona maneno ikiisha kwa mdomo. The teacher was talking, but there was nothing coming out of the mouth. Anaongea na hakuna kitu inatoka kwa mdomo. He was unable to handle that class that day. I felt so guilty. I had dismantled a whole graduate at Form 2. I felt so guilty. I said, me and my big mouth, what am I going to do this month? And then the whole class was excited. There is no lesson. But me, I'm feeling so guilty. Why have I done? Ooh, me and my big mouth. So I had destroyed a teacher. And that teacher struggled with our class for a very long time. Till we went to Form 3 and we were changed to the chemistry teacher. I also struggled with chemistry, courtesy of that. You know, and everything went south from that time. Why? The teacher came in not full. The cup was empty. So I emptied what was left. And so, teachers, you have to be cognizant of your weaknesses so that you know when you are running empty. Sometimes you will ask for, hey, excuse me, I need some refilling. I am feeling like this class is finishing me. And I know I am speaking to some teachers here who COVID-19 was, thank you, Jesus, you have sent this, this break. This class was going to finish me. But now here you are, they are back. And you don't know. So you have to work on yourself. Work on yourself. So very important that you begin to work on yourself so that these areas that we are talking of are dealt with.